Hello, in this video I will show and try to explain how to work with the TechDraw Workbench. For this, I designed a piece that I think is good to exemplify. On top of the FreeCAD, I will select the TechDraw Workbench. Once we select the workbench, we can see that almost all tools are unavailable. Only two tools are available at the moment. First, we need to create a drawing page. For this, we have a tool, insert a new drawing page from template, which allows you to choose one of the several options from this list. You can choose a simple page, but you also have a lot of options with different sizes and also with a place to write information about the drawing. If you want to delete the page, you can go to Combo View, Model, search for the pages, select and delete. You can also use the tool Insert New Default Page, this one. It will open by default this page, and for me it's good to exemplify the tools in this video. More tools can now be used, and the next tool to show is Insert a New View of Active Drawing. If you click on the tool, a message appears and says cannot make a view from this selection. That's because we need to select the part first and then click on the tool. Once the view is created, we can move it around. And in the property table, we can change several parameters such as scale of the view. We can increase or decrease. The next tool allows you to insert multiple views of the same part. We select the part and after clicking on the icon opens the projection group window. You can move it, the view around, but here, if you want to change the scale, we have to choose custom scale. Only then are we allowed to change the scale. We can also choose the type of projection. Clicking on this arrow, we can choose between first angle or third angle. By clicking on these blue arrows, you can change the main view. In these boxes below, we can select the complementary views that we want to add to our drawing. In order to explain the next tools, I will leave only these two views. At the end, we click OK. The next tool is to insert a view of a section. Clicking on a tool will show this message. We have to select the view that we want to get the section view. I will select this view, select the view and click on the tool. Then, the quick section parameters window appears. Here, we can change the symbol that identifies the view. By default, it is the letter A. Below, we have some orange squares that are used to choose the section orientation. If you click once, it shows the view, and the second click shows where the cut is done. To choose another view, it is necessary to click on the reset button first. I will opt for this type of cut, but at the moment it is not in the best position. We have to move it a little to show a best view of the section. We can change the origin coordinates in these three boxes. I will only move it in a Y direction, but to accept the change, you need to press the orange square again. In this position, the cut shows well the detail of the holes, but to be even clear, I am going to reverse the cut. So we will have a clear and simple section view. I will change the symbol just to illustrate. I change to the letter B. The next tool lets you insert a detail view of a part of another view. Once again, we select the view where we want to show the detail first, then click on the detail tool. A dashed square showing the detail area appears in the view, and somewhere on the page appears a circle showing the detail. We can move the circle wherever we want, and once again we can change several parameters in the property table, for example the scale. We can also reposition the location of the detail or the coordinates of the anchor point. In this case, it makes sense to move a little on the X axis. If you are not satisfied, you can still moving until you get in the right place. We also have a tool that allows you to add text. If you want to change the text, do not fall on the mistake of trying to write here, because it will not let you change the text. As you can see. To change the text, first we must click where you have the 3 points. It will open this window. And here you can change the text. Then click OK. Once again, we can change several parameters on a property table. The next three tools are tools that I will not show how to use, but I can say that this one is to insert a draft. This one is to insert a view of an arc section plane. And the last one is to insert a view of a spreadsheet. These next three tools, I do not know what they are for, and I apologize for it. But the next group of tools, this yellow, is to insert and add dimensions to your drawing. To use these tools, you must always select something first. To use the first dimensioning tool, we have to go to one of our views and select 2 points. When we select 1 point, the point must be green, so we have to hit the control button and select the 2 points. Then we click on the icon of the tool and it will show the shortest distance between those selected 2 points. The next tool works the same way, but only indicates the horizontal distance. Again, we have to select two points. We can select any points, but it will only show the horizontal distance, not the shortest distance. We also have a tool for vertical distance. There is one tool to show the radius and another tool to show the diameter. To use these tools, we have to select the circumference where we want to show the dimension, and next we click on the icon. Now you can see how useful this section view can be to add information to our drawing. We also have a tool to show the angle between two lines. So first we select the lines that make the angle. And click on the icon. The last tool from this group allows you to create a link between a dimension and a 3D geometry. In this case, I will apply in the radius of this circumference. For that, we have to select this circumference here on a page and also in the 3D geometry. Make sure that you select the same circumference in your drawing and 3D geometry. Once you select the two, click on the tool and it will open this window. Then you choose the dimensions that you want to use for the link. And finally click OK. We have a tool to export our page to a SVG file. We also have a tool identified as Etch a Face using an image file. To use, we have to select a face, and after selecting a face, it will be filled with green lines. The next tool lets you fill a face with custom geometry and color. For example, I select this face and then click on the tool, opens this window. Here you can change the color. I will choose red this time. And also you can change the, click OK and change the parameters of the geometry. To apply the final result, you must click OK. We have a tool to import symbols from an SVG file. I have here on my PC an SVG symbol to exemplify. And like the detail view and the other views, we can move it around, change the scale, and change the other parameters. We also have a tool for inserting a bitmap of a file. And this tool that looks like a forbidden signal is used to turn on or off the frames of the views. Without the frames on, you cannot move the views, but the detail and the SVG file, we can still move. The last tool just makes a redraw of the page. And if you want to write information about the drawing, you must have activated the frames. Then it will show a green area and you can click. It will open this window and here you can write information about your drawing. I think I have shown everything I know about the TechDraw Workbench. I hope it was helpful. So, hasta.